I forgot that my thing is connected. Man, I'm an idiot.
Save the configs. But oh well. Another time for another day. Oh god.
Yeah, that's not good.
Man, I should really be brushing my teeth more.
Halfway there.
Care about your
Boogie recently announcing
story.
That he's basically broke shouldn't be a surprise to anyone, as if you follow all of his incredibly poor choices made over the last 4 and a bit years, you'll understand that bankruptcy was almost unavoidable. So let's begin by looking at October 2018, in which Boogie's main source of income, his YouTube channel, slowly began to die. Up until this point, Boogie had established a reputation as an overweight yet friendly nerdy gamer, who people considered charming since he was totally fine with each of his flaws. When he wasn't playing his fat Francis character, Boogie was telling wholesome stories about his personal life, with one of the more notable ones being a video titled What It's Like to Be Broke. In this video, Boogie explained that he had grown up in a fairly poor environment.
So they had decent income, it's just they didn't like to spend it on us kids, at least on me.
And that as a result of that, he was not much wiser with his income.
Now, you know what I do with my money? Every single dime, every single penny goes into the bank, because I don't ever, ever want to live that way again.
Which felt both inspiring and relatable, especially since Boogie highlighted that he now only spent money on things that would improve his videos.
I used every dime to buy better computer equipment, to get better. And after just a year and a half, I was able to go off because I started earning my YouTube income.
This desire to improve the content unsurprisingly led to uploads, and by early 2014, Boogie passed 1 million subscribers before uploading a new video simply titled How Much Money Does Boogie2988 Make, which felt like yet another wholesome yet modest upload, which had clearly been made with the goal of helping his audience.
I want to make sure you have the tools in mind so that you fully understand how much income we already have coming in and make an educated decision of whether or not you ever want to participate.
Budget and pay over time with a firm. Visit Casper.com/financing.
No, where's my mountain? Do I keep it in the microwave?
Yeah, did you drink my Mountain Dew? Did you drink my Mountain Dew? Let me smell your breath. Let me smell your breath. Oh, you Mountain Dew drinking bitch. Drinking out of a Mountain Dew. I'm gonna find my Mountain Dew. Who drank my motherfucking Mountain Dew? You sons of bitches. Oh, you sons of bitches. You motherfuckers. Ew, Mountain Dew. Delicious. I'm thirsty for Fago. Are you thirsty for Fago?
Yeah.
You thirsty? It's delicious! I don't want to say no! I want a Mountain Dew! I want my goddamn Mountain Dew! I'm gonna find it. I'm gonna find my goddamn Mountain Dew. Yeah, did you drink my Mountain Dew? Did you drink my Mountain Dew? Let me smell your breath. Let me smell your breath! Oh, you Mountain Dew drinking bitch! Drink it out of a Mountain Dew! I can't afford Mountain Dew! Okay? The economy's rough right now! Obama! You son of a bitch! Afford Mountain Dew! Okay? The economy's rough right now! Obama! You son of a bitch! Mountain Dew drinking bitch! Drink it out of a Mountain Dew!
It's Mountain Lightning, Francis.
I can't afford Mountain Dew! Okay? The economy's rough right now! Obama! You son of a bitch! I'm gonna find my Mountain Dew! I'm gonna find my Mountain Dew! My Mountain Dew! Did you drink? Oh! Oh my god! Mountain Dew. I'm gonna find it. I'm gonna find my goddamn Mountain Dew. Yeah, did you drink my Mountain Dew? Did you drink my Mountain Dew? Let me smell your breath. Let me smell your breath. Oh, you Mountain Dew drinking bitch. Drink it out of a Mountain Dew.
It's Mountain Lightning, Francis.
I can't afford Mountain Dew. Okay? The economy's rough right now. Obama! You son of a bitch!
Whoever wanted to participate in that kind of thing.
Boogie went on to politely imply that he was making over $100,000 per year from YouTube, which didn't include third-party income like Patreon.
So let's take, for example, a YouTube channel similar to mine that's bringing in 10 million views per month. If a YouTube channel is bringing in 10 million views per month, divide that by 1,000, you've got 10,000, multiply that by $1, and you'll have a really good idea of how much ad revenue that channel is bringing in.
And that if you counted his YouTube channel as an asset, he himself was worth more than $1 million.
Boogie, are you a millionaire? Well, it depends on how you calculate millionaire. If you include my YouTube channel as it is, yes. After 3 more years, I'll have earned by then $1 million total in YouTube ad revenue.
This was followed by Boogie reassuring his audience that all of the money was being used wisely.
The majority of the money we make goes into the bank. We do not live very large by any stretch of the imagination. I mean, obviously, I'm large, but we do not spend a grotesque amount of money.
Which led to more positive comments such as, wild guess, but he's very rich now. He deserves it. He's one of the only YouTubers that didn't let the money and fame get to his head. He's still just as humble and cool as when he started. I admire that. Amazing video, Boogie. You're one of the realest, most transparent YouTubers out there, and please know that your fans appreciate it. I clicked on this video randomly and I stayed to watch, and to be honest, I'm really happy this guy makes a lot of money. Don't know him, never seen his videos, but I'm just glad that he makes money. He's very humble.
Any questions about my personal life? Abandoned. No, I don't got any friends, dude. No person deserves this kind of ridicule. Like, I hate my f***ing life at this point. My grandma's dying. I spend my entire life sitting in this room. I had $1,400 worth of chargebacks come out, and all you do is get picked on and criticized. But that's my life. Most of you guys are cracked under the stress that these people put me through.
I just want to escape the bullying.
I do.
People make fun of me and pick at me.
I'm pretty much defeated in every aspect of my life.
You know, I have no self-esteem to begin with, and I feel like nobody loves me, but guess what? It's okay, he's an easy target.
If you haven't heard of his name before, I guarantee you, you're definitely not going to forget it from this point onwards.
I detest this game. I hate you too. Honestly, can you stop, Pedro?
Ban everybody that says I got home.
I'm done. I'm sorry, I'm done with the stream.
Geordie Jordan, aka Wings of Redemption, was born on the 21st of April 1986 into what you might call unfortunate circumstances. His birth had been the result of a teenage pregnancy, and due to the young age of his parents, Geordie would be raised with the help of his grandparents in their trailer park home. At the age of two, his father, an alcoholic, would abandon the family entirely, giving us a pretty clear idea of the unfortunate means by which Wings of Redemption had been brought into the world. However, while the circumstances were far from desirable, as Geordie Jordan entered school, he would begin to excel in sports, claiming to be one of the most athletic people in his class, until a physically gifted foreign exchange student joined his year, placing Geordie in second place for most school sporting events. In order to counteract this, Geordie explained that he began to eat more during dinner time, under the assumption that it would help him grow faster, hopefully giving him a physical advantage over his opponents. However, this would cause Geordie to begin gaining excessive weight, ultimately leading to a sporting underperformance and isolation into the fantasy world of video games. In the process of this, his family, including his brother and single mum, would move from his grandparents' trailer park home into low-income government housing, where Geordie Jordan would continue to gain weight while further isolating himself from society. By the age of 14, he had reached approximately 240 pounds or 110 kilograms, also being diagnosed with bipolar and social anxiety disorder, adding to the isolation even further. To counteract this, Geordie Jordan would begin to take on various low-skilled jobs in order to get out of the house more often, as well as earn himself a little bit of income. In his late teens, he would take on various positions such as working at a video rental store, a supermarket as a 911 operator, and even as a Domino's pizza delivery driver. However, he found many of these to be boring and unstimulating, often leading him to quit within only 2 weeks of starting. However, at the age of 18, Geordie Jordan would finally get into a position which he was able to hold for some period of time, specifically a job working for a company by the name of Metglass.
What I did at Metglass is I was an overhead crane operator for blast furnaces that basically poured liquid metal and things out, kind of like Terminator 2.
While working at Metglass in 2007, Geordie and another friend by the name of Z7 Taylor would play Call of Duty in the evenings, also starting to regularly watch sniper montages over on YouTube. In the process, Geordie thought about making his own videos, however, given his busy work schedule, would dismiss the idea as he had minimal time for doing so. However, in 2008, an event would occur that presented itself as a negative in the beginning, however, would turn out to be a huge turning point in his life, the global financial crisis. Geordie explained that since he was one of the more expensive employees at Metglass, he was one of the first to lose their job as business profits began to tumble.
They started laying people off, and one of the people that got laid off was one of the newer employees, and I was also getting paid more than most of the employees on the flat factory floor.
He would then be put on government unemployment payments, which in combination with his previous employment history seemed to dampen Geordie Jordan's confidence in relation to his ability to hold down a job working for someone else.
If you think I could hold a job down, you're kidding yourself. The reason I don't get a job is I can't hold one down.
However, there was one advantage to come out of this whole situation. Suddenly, Geordie Jordan had all the time in the world. His friend Z7 Taylor had started making his own Call of Duty videos and noticing the success of them.
Because I see Taylor and his channel and I love reading the comments, so I'm like, man.
He would order a HD PVR capture card.
Mamma mia!
Mario!
Hey guys, Super Horror Bro Mike here, and in today's video we are going to be reacting to the Project Playtime cinematic and gameplay trailers. Now I'm recording this intro, I've done that. Oh, then grabs a bron. Oh, okay. So are these going to be the people we're playing as? With their little grab hands. They've got like grab hands guns. We've got a huggy wuggy. Or at least I think that's a huggy. Yeah, that's a huggy. See, this is like a co-op game, so I'm guessing we play... Oh my god! It comes to life, what the heck? comes to life and it wriggles around. Damn, that's brutal. He stomps it out. The toys containing their blood, of course. Oh my god, Huggy got him. So we get Huggy Wuggy in this game, that's pretty cool. This is kind of a savage trailer for Poppy Playtime.
Yeah, it's supposed to be fucking
scary.
Ooh,
he's got grabbed as well. Man,
ooh,
this is nuts.
Hug.
Trailer for Poppy Playtime.
Yeah, a hug and then he ate.
Ooh, he's got grabbed as well. Man, this is nuts. You could actually make a really cool, like, animated movie out of this. Ah, so we're gonna have mechanics like that where we can shut doors to keep enemies out. We've got train station. Oh, we've got Mommy Longlegs in this as well. That's actually awesome. So it seems like this multiplayer game's gonna have, like, loads of characters, you know, loads of enemies and stuff in it. We've got a jack in the box there, look. With a star on it.
Oh yeah, this is the new one.
Stuck on a train with that. He's like, oh. Oh man, what is this?
Oh,
it's like a honey monster.
No, that's someone different entirely.
Oh.
Oh, there he is.
Oh no,
there's
it comes
the
life whole box. I wasn't expecting that. Holy moly, that is creepy.
That's pretty creepy.
It would be sick. Oh,
that's
no,
pretty cool. I like that
box.
One.
I
actually
that.
Love that. I love that character design. And the way it goes in, it's kind of funny.
Holy moly, that is creepy.
It's kind of funny.
It's like a honey monster. What is that? Oh. Oh no, it comes to life a whole box. I wasn't expecting that. Holy moly, that is creepy.
It's kind of funny.
I'm stuck on a train with that. I'm keeping up with this set, huh? How many long legs in this is... Can you make a really cool, like, animated movie out of this? Ah, so we're gonna have mechanics like that where we can shut doors to keep enemies out. We've got train station. Oh, we've got Mommy Longlegs in this as well. That's actually awesome. So it seems like this is gonna have, like, loads of characters, you know, loads of enemies and stuff in it. Got a jack in the box there, look. With a star on it.
Man, I love that character design.
What the heck is this? I haven't been keeping up with this new game, guys, so I don't know what this is, but...
Me neither, but this is fun. I'm
guessing it's a new enemy.
That is such a fun design.
Then pops out of a box. Imagine being stuck on a train with that. He's like, oh. Oh man, what is this?
This is such
a
fun design. I love that design so much.
Oh.
Look at that.
Oh no, it comes
to
life
out of
a box. I wasn't expecting that. Holy moly, that is creepy.
That is
such
a fun design.
Oh no, it comes to life out of a box.
I love that.
I wasn't expecting... Like honey
the
monster.
Whole box is
gone. What is that? Oh,
oh I love it. I
oh
love
no,
this.
It comes to life a whole box. I wasn't expecting that. Holy moly, that is creepy. It would be sick if that's like in chapter 3 as well. Like that enemy. Because that is a creepy enemy. But that's a new enemy for the multiplayer game. So here it is, Project Playtime. That is the name of this game, of course. This has a name, but I don't actually know what the name of it is, so I might put it on
Boxy
screen now.
Boo,
it's known.
Which is
do the research environment, and then Mommy Longlegs as well. And then we have this new jack-in-the-box type enemy, which probably has a name, but I don't actually know what the name of it is, so I might put it on screen now if it's known. Do a bit of research after this video. So we've actually got a gameplay trailer as well, guys, on the Steam page, so let's check that out and see what the gameplay looks like. Hey, Leif Pierre. How's it going?
And welcome to your job as a resource extraction specialist.
Ooh, new environment.
You will need to collect toy cars to make a giant toy.
Ah.
Put that toy on the train, then leave.
So it's about making toys up, and we can hide in lockers. That's kind of cool. Oh, we got third person as well. This actually looks pretty good. Play both sides. Oh, so some people play as the toys. And other people play as the people running about. That's actually neat.
That's pretty cool.
This actually looks pretty advanced. So we run away from the toys, yeah, try and hide, and we have to try and escape by building a toy. Wow, that's actually neat. Wow. This actually looks pretty good. Play both sides. Some people play as the toys, and other people play as the, well, this actually looks pretty good. Play both sides. Oh, so some people play as the toys, and other people play as the, give him a box there, look.
Yeah, I love that.
Oh, he's got grabbed. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, I love the...
This is kind
of a sad. I love the different direction eyes. That is such a fun design.
Oh, he's got grabbed as well. Man, this is nuts. You could actually make a really cool, like, animated movie out of this. Ah, so we're gonna have mechanics like that where we can shut doors to keep enemies out of the station. Oh, we've got Mommy Longlegs in this as well. That's actually awesome. So it seems like this multiplayer game's gonna have, like, loads of characters, you know, loads of enemies and stuff in it. Got a jack in the box there, look. With a star on it. What the heck is this? I haven't been keeping up with this new game, guys, so I don't know what this is, but... I'm guessing it's a new enemy, right? Something pops out of a box. Imagine being stuck on a train with that. He's like, oh. Oh man, what is this? It's like a honey
man,
monster.
I love how this guy is animated,
what
though.
Is
it's so beautiful.
Oh no, it comes to life a whole box. I wasn't expecting that. It's like a honey monster. What is that? Oh. Oh no, it comes to life a whole box. I wasn't expecting that. It's like a honey monster. What is that? Oh. Oh no, it comes to life a whole box. I wasn't expecting that.
Man, that's fun. That's a fun character design, and I love the movement on it. Really stepping up their game. Really stepping up their game.
Here we go, 4-3. Haunted? Oh my.
No, it's just a...
Oh my god. Wait, even the little ones are haunted? Oh my.
They're not haunted or alive.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Wait, they actually bleed. They do bleed. I knew it.
Of course they do.
Uh oh. Oh. Oh my gosh! Oh my! Okay, man. They know what they're doing, man. These thumbnail shots are too good. Holy moly! Look at that thing. Oh my god! Imagine that in multiplayer? This looks insane! Holy. Oh, heading to the train station. Whoa! Mommy Longlegs! What is she doing? Okay, so everyone's here. 9512. I wonder if that number's important. I don't know. Oh my. Oh, look at the little box in there with them. Look at the box. Uh-oh. I love this. Oh, you poor fella. What the heck is that? What is that?
It's
What the heck? How do they think of this stuff? That is awesome. That's like from Dark Souls. Like, you know, the chest that you open is the incorrect one and it eats you? Oh.
Today I arranged the weirdest Minecraft build battle probably ever. I wanted to once and for all see who can make the best cannon big cannons. But obviously, I'm not gonna lose this, right? I am the create small dumbs it do. Yeah, there's no way I'm losing this. So I invited my friend Theo, who knows nothing about create big cannons. Sponsored by World of Warships. A cannon.
Okay, first order of business. Weed the place. Oh, I missed. Okay. As an added chance for the cannon video.
We're making cannons with great big cannons. You have to look at this thing right here, the squib cannon loader, and they shoot the shell out. Anything else?
And that's a cannon. How do I make this good? What the? Bro, this cannon's bad. I'm fine, dude. This this is gonna be fine, okay? And what if I just put this here and then just use command blocks so that it's supposed over here and then it's technically a cannon.
So now that we know that a cannon works, it's time to make it controllable. To do that we need a controller. See, I'm starting to learn this now.
So welcome to a new world. Of course, some things need to be done beforehand. Alright, fast. And everything else fast. Those who fancy you fast. Animations decrease quality. Turn natural textures on, so it's better. Bit of grass. Yep. Leaving that. Performance. Yep. I think that's it. Alright. Now we are finally beginning. I thought that was a charm. Oh, damn. Well, you live, you learn. Ring. There it is. There it is. There's ring. Alright. I got this. Now, first rule of business is to get wool, and also out of here, because I think this place has wasps to deal with. Build my own house. Thank you very much. It'd be nice, but I would like to build my own. Because it's more fun. Yeah, I guess I'll stay away from it. Shit. Come on. Fuck. I gotta walk between a rock and a hard place. Hold on.
really stuck between a rock and a hard place. What the hell? For a minute. There you go, there's glass over there. Man, there's some fire, isn't there? I don't know if you're above ground or below. Not below. Or below. I'm guessing there's chests under the sand, but I don't really want to stay here for too long, so I'll just walk in, see what's happening, and walk away. Nope. Nope. No, no, no. Fuck those guys. They're absolute dick loggers. Just, as long as I don't walk in the cockatoo, I'm all good. No, it's a meteor. Alright, better than a dragon's nest. Alright, no cockadills or whatever the fuck they are. The shit that looks at you when you turn into stone, those guys. Further that way. 700 blocks? Maybe I could do that. I think I might have to dig a hole for the night. We'll find. Oh, it is really flat. I could start here. But the thing is, should I? Yeah, there's nothing around. Is that a swamp or... Shit, is this a swamp island? No, it doesn't be a swamp island. Oh, maybe jungle? I don't know if there's a jungle over there. No, there's grass. Okay, it's jungle. Alright. So it's a jungle biome. But I have no clue what the whole swamp is. So, I'm gonna do the smartest thing. Hide underground. Sunset. Now I have to wait. Fisk of the sand. Fisk of the sand. I don't know what that means. Oh no, wait. No, those are in pure deserts, I believe. First night, I'm going to. Not the best right now, but. I don't know when sunrise appears. Or... yeah, I'll just stay here. Won't stay around for too long. Yeah, I got a thing, right? Yeah, I got a thing.
Spellstone shift. Okay. Let's go twice. Alright. Passive abilities. Immune to fire. Oh, immunity to fire. Oh, okay. Passive ability absent. Passive abilities. Immunity to fire. Temporarily immune to lava. Burns those who attack you. In melee. Any. Why? Status effect. Down twice as fast, except. What? So, fire resistance lasts twice as long. You are vulnerable to under. You are vulnerable to underwater creatures. Oh, that was weird. That's just like a bunch of hostiles right above me. A skeleton, which is not cool. I would like to have some chests before then. Oh yeah, I got that call. Oh, that's stupid. Oh, damn. Oh, sweet. Alright, I just want to go over. Okay. Turn these into sticks. Which I could put in here. I don't need that right now. Rebounding. I don't know what that is. Actually, I think I should figure out the help rebounding is so I can put on better armor. Yep. I'll keep that. Just here. I don't need that right now. That is just useless. That's the fire chest. Torches are cheap. Mana regeneration. Wow, that's cool and all, but I don't want to learn. Okay. You're confusing me a little bit now, but I have to talk to my counselor about that. It's getting light. The jungle's edge. It's pretty scary out here. No, it's fine. All good. Whenever you die, you'll have no equipment in your inventory. Summons extra commercial. Oh, okay. That's nice. Nursing is open. I'm going to make a watch. Before I can change. Interesting.
Well, that's great. So, when I die, I'll keep all my stuff. And this, put it in the actual spell slot. I know you can access it from your back, but I don't know how to do that. But I know you can. Controls about that, all right. Let's see. Back pack B. Is that right? All right, so B. No, that's a. Oh. Well then, I guess I have to change that. Actually, waypoint away. Map. Alright, what the hell is B? Yeah. You could be slash. No, that's not a shit. No. There you go. That'll work. So, my theory. Alright. Oh, that's nice. That's actually real nice. You know, I think I should actually do my bed. Desert. Not be so clear. Gorillas, they're neutral, they're fine, not hostile.
Yeah, both of these biomes could eat me alive, like, no problem. Either a cockatoo, sandworm, and or everything else. That is, aka, the jungle. Stay to the side. And not face any rabid dinosaur birds. That'd be fuck. Also not a good spot because of alligators. There's got to be somewhere to live that isn't dangerous 90% of the time. And I really, really don't want to. Because I just don't want to. There's no crocodiles in the bottom. Yeah. And also there's a... get my soul be ripped away by an alligator. Hey, a duck. Yay, a duck. Something that's not wanting to kill me. And just stay away from alligators and it'll be fine, right? Is this a forest? What is this? This is different. Nope, it's a willow swamp. Still a swamp. But it's willow this time. Nothing. Nothing cool. Alright. I don't want to walk into that. Okay, don't fuck with me. Don't do it. Don't touch it. Don't touch it. It'll be fine. There we are. It's just the beginning. We've only just begun. Alright, no mobs in front of me. So I should be good for about 2 seconds before I have to turn. I don't know if those are crocodiles, so I'm gonna go that way. Oh, they're right in the water, too. I don't know if they're crocodiles. Nope, squid. Something else. I know there's something else. Either has to be below me or right there, and I'm not taking a shot of where, or why, or how. I just want to get to a safer spot, which is nowhere near here. In fact, maybe just above this hill. The hell is that? That's just... ooh, a village! Okay. And then... an active nether portal. Did that say turret? What in the world? What? Oh no. Zombie man. Alright, I'm just gonna leave that there. For some other people. I don't know, maybe the golems will take care of that eventually? What the hell? bastard just killed me. What? And why am I down here? Excuse me? Fucking rude. God damn it. I gotta get the fuck out of here. Good for me. Knowledge of death. Yay. That's so fun. Getting fucked immediately after seeing a single guy walk in and body me. Thank God I don't have any on the ground. But what the fuck would you... What? Is it fucking command? No. Well, what the fuck are they? I don't know. A reward, yay. I'm so happy to die to a friend. What in the world did I do? What the fuck was I them? Great, I'm all the fucking way over there. Yippee fucking ho. Now I gotta walk all the way fucking there with no food, no shit. Why did you body me? And why in two swings? Aren't they neutral? What the fuck did I do? Fuck his mother before this game? Fucking asshole, man. I thought he was getting the other guy, no? He was going straight to me. Look, I'm only like zero to none about this mod pack, so I know I do. But right now, I am pissed. I thought a village was supposed to be a cool place where you chill out and relax. Not getting fucking bodied by a motherfucker with a sword in it. Cop! What a bastard, man. guess I can figure out what the hell to build. Just looking for a place to settle down. The motherfucker literally fucking bum rushed me in two hits. God damn that guy. Yeah, I'm really all alone in this. So that's great to know. I guess I don't fucking need them then. Oh, really? That's interesting. Oh, yeah, what mine is this? Environmental. And there's these guys. Only three chunks were Dragonite? And even then, it's still a lot. Oh, compact machines are here. It's good to see. And in the glass. Don't know what that is. Lost trinkets. Those look pretty cool. Mechanical crafting. Not fair. Same here as well. Thank you. sand in a dream. All the way back there. At least it kept everything in the thing for me. Because what the fuck? Is he as a zombie or something? Look, I may be green, but I'm not a fucking zombie. Work in progress. A dong, though? Since it's like no trees around here, I can wait until the sun to come out. And just wait for the signs of skeletons dying. It wasn't in the way. Oh! Didn't know that. Didn't know I was here today. And it is. It is pure four anyway. It's a thermal resistance of 100. Heat capacity of 10,000. And hot goes to air. Cold goes to. Oh, there's pure tools. Alright. Alright. I should put these back. I don't want to upset the guy that lives here. If he's nice, tell one of the others. Tell him I'm scrapping. Alright, cool. There's no one. No. What? Get. Let me respawn. Well, don't tell me there's a life system in this. Don't tell me. Don't dare. Yeah, I know that, Autumn. You dick. wasn't on fucking hardcore or anything.
Both activated, so nothing is spinning.
God, this takes so long.
Deactivate this redstone torch here. We should spin to the left. Yeah.
Cannon that worked. It was the hook. You ready? 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 See, that was the cannon that did that. That was the cannon. I'm sure that you can't see the cannon. Oh wait, I don't know what to do. Okay.
Oh my god.
Get one, you know? I'm sure he'll never know, right? He's not gonna notice.
Alright, okay, I'm gonna be sure you guys.
Oh my.
I'll try time to explain what this is, but I'm still gonna do it because I'm cool in that way. A sequence basically lets you decide when and how rotation happens. That's the best way I can explain it. So this one is powered and rotation from over here, but if we look on the other
break.
Side.
Now I gotta wait all fucking
and choose what it does and when it does it. So when this thing gets activated by redstone, it's gonna turn 90 degrees forwards in the speed of the it's gonna end. So if we get a bearing here, for example, and place a block on top of it, and then activate this, you're gonna see this spin 90 degrees to the right. Oh, but since it's a block, it's gonna place itself in the normal orientation. But you saw it rotate, and by using this, we should be able create an automatic loading system for a dumb looking cannon. Two for the powder charges, one for the explosive shell, and let's see, if we power this now, it should place, yes, you can see they're in the wrong orientation. And all the other times I've tried this out, I've thought, well, where do I place the deployers? Where do I have to place them to make them in the correct orientation? But I thought of it the wrong way, and I think you can see the fix right now after I showed you the sequence gear shift and the mechanical bearing. You understand what's happening, right? Just gonna place mechanical bearings underneath and rotate them after they've been placed. How did I not think of this? What? And so if we get sequence gear shifts down here, is that it? So we'll open this up. We will rotate these and we will push them in. Then the cannon gets assembled and it's ready to shoot.
Okay, I suppose. Did I put it here? Wait, it worked. Oh my god. I'm so it says listen, he'll never know, okay? He will never know. I'm gonna go down as the first person in Shell's build battle history that it's cheated to pull it high explosive. Okay, I need to remove these signs and make them something that I write. Bullet high explosive.
But I think I've done it. Actually, for once, for the first time ever. I think it's over. I timed all of these sequence gear shifts to have a delay that should hit everything else, so we should have a hyper-speed automatic loader right in front of us. So these things are going to go up, place the blocks. You're going to get rotated, the time fuse goes on, and then as soon as that's done, this thing should send them in. But before all of that, this one opens up, and as soon as they're in, this one closes. The only thing that's not automated right now is this. Activating and deactivating the cannon, but that's fine, I'll fix that later. I hope this works, and if it does, we should see a bunch of things happen really fast, hopefully so fast that we don't even register what's going on. Alright, let's see, in 3, 2, 1, go!
Fail. Yep.
Oh. Yes! Boo! Finally! Do you know how long I've been trying to make this for? 3, 2, 1, go! Was that it? Is it assembled? Wait.
You began a guided meditation video when you were but now you're taking your practice outdoors.
Oh my, okay, let's make this look a bit better and then we're... Theo!
Charles,
the time is up.
Yeah,
yes, go again.
Okay, I'm in.
Can I do?
Oh, three, two, no, no, no.
Wait, did you actually make a cannon?
Oh, 3, 2, 1.
Oh my god. I saw it in the chat, you know, I pointed it out, but I thought it was... What? Why did
I see three... parts of a cannon behind me. No.
Wait, did you actually make a cannon?
I made a cannon, Charles. Come on.
Can I look at it?
Yeah, you can look. Turn around. And isn't it so much better than your cannon?
What the fuck? Oh my god. I know what cannon this is, Theo. I've seen it.
No, you haven't.
Yeah,
that
I have.
That is a big lie. That
I had it sent
lie.
To me the other day. I have seen
the
cannon.
No, you didn't.
What this...
Boom.
What are you doing?
I don't know how to fire the cannon.
Oh, you don't even know how it works? But yet you downloaded a cannon off of the...
No, I didn't download it. I did not download it. turn away for a second. Just turn away.
Okay.
Come back.
Oh my god, no!
So I've got a new one.
It's time. See, that's how you cheat. The only cannon you made is a schematic cannon. This is not even a cannon. This is.
No, alright, first of all, you can't prove I cheated and didn't follow the tutorial. Second
but
of
is
all,
there even a tutorial? You know what? I don't have three cannons. What I do have is a fully automatic cannon made by me. You right click this. Now, press shift once. Just tap it.
Oh,
there we go. And boom, the cannon is loaded.
Oh, can I move?
Yeah, you can move it up, down, left, right.
Oh my god, wait, what? It turns?
Yeah, and then press space.
No shot, what the fuck? And then I reload.
And then
I
reload, so look. It just goes down and it closes.
Oh,
it's so fucking good.
What the fuck?
I won. It's been
okay, if we're being serious,
For once, Theo.
If we're being serious, I think my little cannon won.
If you know, I've been streaming on my Crate Bed SMP almost daily recently, but I've done some things, and my base is now under constant threat of attack. So I need a way to protect myself, and that's where Create Big Cannon comes in. Thank you, so what I'm gonna do is I'm going to fucking automate this. We're making a remote controlled cannon that we can control wherever. I'm not quite sure how that's cool. It's steel for loading. If I activate it, I can no longer place blocks on it, and it is now a cannon. It's a contraption. So let's see what happens if we power it from underneath. Nothing from the side. Oh, that's the up and down motion. How do I make it turn? Your controller, there we go. I put this in the bottom. Ah, yeah. Imagine you're just out chilling, playing Minecraft, you turn it on and you see this. Alright, that's a good first step. I just want to make it so we can actually turn it. That's easy. We just need gear shift and clutches, I believe. So the clutch will make it that it doesn't
turn
all the time.
Crashed.
The gear shift will enable
what, why didn't that make you look? For goddamn.
I don't want to build anything else
thing.
Until I know that the actual cannon works. Because that is the most important part. So, we need to.
Right, what they did in the thing?
Yes, they unlock it and then they move it up so you can charge the cannon. Charge? Load. I think there was some sort of pushing thing we needed. A ram. Ram head, yep. And this thing, cannon loader. So we get the cannon loader right here. Two extension poles and the ram head on here. Boom. Create the motor, lever on top. I think this should all work, so we just push it in now.
Oh.
And then, when I remove this, it should just be, yeah. Anyways, let's close it and see if it works. Right, there we go, assemble. And if I'm not mistaken, we power it from the front, right here. 3, 2, 1. Okay, kind of a big fail, because it went into the water. I don't know about you, but that, yeah, that did work. And fire. It still went into the water, really? Oh! That's so good! Oh, it's so satisfying when you spend time... Oh, look at the smoke trail as well. But now it's time to make it remote controlled, because, I mean, I'm not going to be able to control it, and that actually says... No, and as soon as we release it stops. Now, I just have to do it for the rest of it. Also, don't forget to subscribe! To delay where the repeaters have to get activated. Whoa, I think this is all working. I haven't tested it yet. So if we activate it now, W and S works. Okay, D works, but A does up. I know why. This is not a receiver. Schmack. There we go. A, D, W, and S. Oh, that's mad. That's actually maybe makes it a bit faster. Whoa, can I attach a seat to this thing? I'm gonna cry if I can. Can I sit? If I can sit with the... I. Oh, if this works. No. So now that we can move it up, down, and side to side, I think it's time to make it shoot whenever I press space. That makes sense, right? Space feels very much like control. Space is the one above, I think. And there we go. Press space now. We activate the shooting part. Ha! Activate it, and let's see where we want to shoot. To the right, and let's see if we can hit that tree right there. And then we press space to shoot. Shoot! I moved this up. I charged it with powder charge and high explosive shell with a fuse. I put it in there, moved this back. I closed it, I screw it tight, and then I assembled it.
that should be it, right? You should be able to just turn it and press space to... No! Okay, so I did a thing. This right here is my first almost working prototype of the defense system for my base. Now, as automatic base, things that go into the cannon here, and then they need to be pushed in. Fill this chest of this thing. That almost worked. Okay, so we have a couple issues here. First off, this thing was in the way, it's now moved, but these things were placed in the wrong orientation, which is not good.
How to solve?
I'm gonna have to go back to the drawing board then, I guess, figure out a new way to charge it. I could just use a bunch of deployers, really. I could just have a bunch of deployers, but I wanted it to be at least a little bit, you know, effective, cost-effective. But
then again, I don't even know if this entire setup is gonna work, or if it's just gonna explode like the last one.
Okay, so I started on the loading system, and I believe I've made the first thing happen. So we need to disassemble the cannons first, and then we need to screw them out, right? So they're assembled now, and if I pick up the controller and press shift, you should see these get deactivated, which deactivates and deassembles the cannons. And then these things should all get screwed out. Let's see. 3, 2, 1. It's disassembled, and this is spinning, but they're not being... Could there be a... Oh, wow, this redstone here is powering the gear shift. That's a problem. Okay, right, let's just place another one here with the same speed and just move the gear shift down. I think that's our solution. Yeah, when we connect this, they should get screwed up. Oh, that was too quick to even see. Nice. Pressing shift, disassembles the cannons, screws this out. Now I just need them to move up quickly as well. So as soon as I screw this one to just... This is probably going to be one of the coolest things I've ever built. Wow. Actually, holy shish, this has taken a lot longer than I thought, but I am pretty sure we have a functioning thing now. It doesn't turn, that's the thing, it doesn't go up, down, left, or right yet. But I need to test it out before I do anything else. So I've copied it, because I am not about to break that thing that took me so long to make. I'm going to suppress this when it's not activated. Alright, I think we have everything we need. I think it is indeed set up. I'm so scared. When I now press shift, this thing will activate in 3, 2, 1... Go. Oh no, it didn't work at all. It did. Oh no. Well, good thing I saved it, because Jesus, that was a mistake. All right, we will assemble the cannons. Boom, and press next shift. Let's go. Oh, I know what's wrong! I know what's wrong! I didn't move this with the thing. I forgot to glue them to the thing. Was that the only issue? Actually, I'm confused at this point, because it seems like it's working, except for these small things that I've forgotten. So this time it was just some super glue that was needed. And I can fix that real quick. Let's see. Will it work? Let's go. Why aren't you spinning in the correct direction? Oh! I think it worked! I think it worked! Wait, let's try shooting one of them! Oh! Oh! One of them shot! Why did only one of them shoot?
What? Let's just activate all the cannons and see if it works this time, maybe, for most of them at least. Screw it out. Everything was going the wrong way. I think this is gonna be a failure. The automatic loading system, with all of this, with all the turning stuff, it seems I reached my limit. We kind of did it though, okay? You can't say I didn't do it at all, because we did have two cannons that could shoot up here, okay? Two of them actually did shoot. But don't you worry, I will be back, and I will make the cannon system better than anything you've ever seen before.
Zycans love Zycans unique zinc formula. It's short, it's cold. Zycans zinc, that cold.
Sea stars losing their arms all over the place and falling away.
From Alaska to Mexico, among at least 20 different starfish species. Sometimes, one torn arm sort of eats the rest, acting like a zombie. So what's this all about?
Trigger! Let's go shoot me! Shoot me! Shoot me!
don't care.
Cheese actually is. Well, for starters, there is definitely no rabbit involved in a Welsh rarebit. And I said rarebit right now because rabbit is the 18th century name for this English dish. I could sum this up as an open-faced grilled cheese. And it's made from a beer, mustard, and mature English cheddar cheese sauce. It's absolutely fantastic, and as always, there is no time to waste. Now, let's go! One of the most famous restaurants that serves this dish is located in London, and it's called St. John's. Now, lucky for us, my brother worked there for years. I just consulted with him about how to make this Welsh rarebit. So we've got the best information possible. Let's go over the ingredients to start. So the first thing you're going to need is 2 knobs of butter. And you may be wondering, what is a knob of butter? And that is exactly how the recipe is listed from St. John's. If you look this up, a knob of butter is anywhere from 1 to 4 tablespoons. But I am considering 1 knob, 2 tablespoons of butter. We're going to use that butter in combination with this all-purpose flour to build a basic little roux. The liquid we're using for the base of this Welsh rarebit has to be Guinness. You could use another stout or dark ale if you want, but Guinness is definitely preferred. We'll then be adding a comical amount of mature English cheddar. Get the oldest cheddar you possibly can. And if you're watching from the UK right now, you might be able to find cheddar from Monty's or Montgomery's. Those are the two that were recommended to me. I couldn't find them, but any strong.
And also, why the hell was I not running?
And probably one of the most key ingredients in this whole dish is Worcestershire sauce.
I don't understand.
You gotta have this, and Lee and Perrins is the brand that you want. We'll follow that up with Coleman's English mustard powder from the UK, and it is the preferred.
I must have been clicking shift like
a
stupid ass.
You're also gonna need a little cayenne pepper to give this dish a little kick. And finally, just a good old fashioned loaf of white bread.
I think I'll just probably end it there because I have to leave like in 30 minutes.
So we need clarified butter. It's really easy to make. I'm gonna show.
Hurry up! That's what f***ing with us? He was insane! Out of control! He would have f***ed me too if you had come along!
It's almost a grand idea!
What are you two talking about?
We f***ing the health inspector!
Let me spell it for you. F is for friends who'd f*** together. U is for you and me.
I feel all tingly inside. Should we stop?
No, that's how you're supposed to feel.
Well, I like it. Let's f*** again!
Okay!
And after that, we f*** the flowers.
Hi, Mr. Plankton.
Haven't you f*** me enough for one day?
No, I mean, I want you to come out and f*** me.
All right.
F*** me.
Haven't you f*** me?
No, that's how you're supposed to, for you and me.
I feel all tingly inside. Should we stop?
No, that...
Sunshine with 100% orange juice and no added sugar. Tropicana.
Together, U is for you and me.
cool.
And is for anywhere and any time at all.
Down here in the deep blue sea. F is for fire that burns down the whole town. U's for uranium bombs. N is for no survivors when you're...
Plankton. Those things aren't what fun is all about. Now, do it like this. F is for friends who do stuff.
Never. That's completely idiotic.
Here, let me help you. F is for friends who do stuff together. U is for you and me. Try it!
N is for anywhere at any time at all. Down here in the deep blue sea.
Wait, I don't understand this. I feel all tingly inside. Should we stop?
No, that's how you're supposed to feel.
Well, I like it. Let's do it again!
Okay!
F is for Colin.
Fun
it.
You are
the prize. For you, Galen.
I'm not walking 1,000 blocks to be bodied by a damn guard. But, you know, fuck it, you know? Yeah. Oh, you're a dick. Hey, you're just that absolute ginormous piece of shit.
Should we stop?
No, that's how you're supposed to feel.
Well, I like it. Let's do it again.
I thought that I had... It's not about winning. It's about fun.
What's that?
It's so
fun
long.
Fun is... It's like...
No, I already
it's kind
have
of...
Fucking things.
Sort of like a... What is fun? Let me spell it. F is for friends who do stuff together. U is for you and me. N is for anywhere and any time at all.
Down here in the deep blue sea. F is for fire that burns down the whole town. U's for uranium bombs. N is for no survivors when you're...
Plankton. Those things aren't what fun is all about. Now, do it like this. F is for friends who do stuff.
Never! That's completely idiotic.
Here, let me help you. F is for friends who do stuff together. U is for you and me. Try it!
N is for anywhere at any time at all.
Down here in the deep blue sea.
Wait, I don't understand this. I feel all tingly inside. Should we stop?
No, that's how you're supposed to feel.
Well, I like it. Let's do it again!
Okay!
F is for Prowlet, you are the flowers. U is for ukulele. N is for nose picking, sharing gum and sand licking here with my best buddy.
I don't care what it is, I'm not buying it.
It's not about winning, it's about fun.
What's that?
Fun is, it's like, it's kind of, sort of like a, let me spell it for you. F is for friends who do together. U is for you and me. N is for anywhere and any time at all.
Down here in the deep blue sea. F is for fire that burns down the whole town. U's for uranium bombs. N is for no survivors when you're...
Plankton. Those things aren't what fun is all about. Now, do it like this. F is for friends who do stuff.
Never! That's completely idiotic.
Here, let me help you. F is for friends who do stuff together. U is for you and me. Try it!
N is for anywhere at any time at all.
Down here in the deep blue sea.
Wait, I don't understand this. I feel all tingly inside. Should we stop?
No, that's how you're supposed to feel.
Well, I like it. Let's do it again!
Okay!
F is for frolic, you are the flowers. U is for ukulele. N is for nose picking, sharing gum and sand licking here with my best buddy. Ha 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 ha
It's not about winning, it's about fun.
I'm just listening to
it.
God, I'm gonna get my
Nerdherders, we're back with a new mod pack. testing things out, testing the water, seeing how we do.
Yeah, it's an experience, all right.
It's
the only monumental thing about it is
it's all vanilla.
The amount of bullshit from that guard and the wait times because my computer is so bad.
The seed for this pack or this playthrough is family with a capital F.
Oh.
You will spawn in the jungle.
Here I am.
Still spawn in the jungle.
I am actually in the worst spot in the world.
But I don't remember. We're gonna build right here though, because what's nice about this?
Oh, that is actually terrible.
Starting house. Now remember, you won't get silent gear unless you put it in yourself. I would want to do. Look at this. We can walk through bushes. I think that's where I played this. I played a little bit last night. I think the volume's up a little bit. Let me turn the volume up just a tad.
Don't click. Don't click. Don't click. Do not click. Thank you. I don't know which one is doing that on me. Can I get to some land? That'd be cool. Why in the middle of buttfuck nowhere, though? Literally in the why? I'm in the worst spot in the world. Are we leaving?
Okay, that's better. Through the bushes.
Yes.
Can you start on the green bean casserole?
What?
All you gotta do is mix the stuff together and put it in the oven.
Alright. I'll be right back.
EMR glasses. Can I come in for a second? I just need to get Ma's glasses. Do you hear me? I need to get Ma's glasses. Do you see them there?
This is the same thing I got last night. I think it's really weird and awkward. But what we're going to do is we're going to place our house down here. It's nice that they give you a compass when you start off there. Can I click here? Oh, okay. The problem is what's going to happen is some of this is going
to
fall.
So don't go to a village.
Maybe we should do it across the way.
No,
like,
body you. And... no remorse.
Yeah,
he'll kill you without a second thought.
Right on the edge, though. So.
Why? I don't know. Maybe I smell the mushroom or something.
That gives you
no glasses.
No glasses?
Nope.
All right. else. I got about 6 minutes before the thing goes off. I gotta get somewhere. Can't stay here. Definitely can't stay here. I'm in the middle of fuck nowhere. Of course I'm not gonna stay here. Does a fish literally leap out of water and fuck me then? No, thank God, but... Okay. There's a forest. Not too far away. Just literally across this. And I should probably just make myself a bed. Okay. Alright, I'm in the forest. Not going that way. I'm going around. Just fuck that. There. If we get the one. Alright, I'm gonna... Alright, I'm gonna call this home for now. I'm just... Just let me get oak. I don't care. What? Just let me spawn here. Let me slab. Good enough for me. There you go. This is where I spawn. This is... this is home for now. For multiple reasons. Butterfly. Those are fine. I should probably, get something built. Oh, don't be right into a goddamn swamp again. Not only to a swamp. Just to add insult to injury, you add a witch hut there. You are an absolute bastard of bastards. Oh, you... gotta be kidding me. You actually have to be kidding me. It is here I'll stay. Right here. Actually, right on that island. Actually, pretty nice. Okay. This place is, it looks pretty peaceful. Alright. Looks nice. I like this area. It's nice. This area is good. Oh wait, isn't this, we should go down to any source, not to pierce yourself. Okay. I think I'll just, get that off. Because that's what fucked me before. Okay, so it's the ring. That ring fucked me. Maybe I'll keep it? Just keep it around. Let me get it over. Actually, I should at least have this spot in here. Alright. functions, any of those things. Performance. Oh, that's the thing. You're here too? Jeez, everyone's here. I think it'll be fast. It's an axe. Seven curses. That is the hard mode. And I was just walking right on in. Yep. Ready to roll. Let's do Earthen House, let's do black. There you go. That's something. Got beans. Got blackberry. Got lavender. That's good. Alright. Alright. Well, this is home. Okie dokie. Alright. I gotta check on my. Alright. Alright, here we are. Yep, we need steak. It's what I have to do. I just slap that more. You can keep the bed. Instead of every single recipe in the world. No creates in here? Yeah, of course it is. Of course creates in here. Why the hell would it? Shit in here. I think I have you. Just a sack of dirt. Alright. I don't really see the point of. Like, building a house if it just gives you a house. Those are fun. Yeah, that's what we're doing. Always right through the middle. Alright, let's get started with whatever the hell we need to do. Alright, I'm guessing this is where all this stuff is. Do I want to do my colonies? No, wait, no. No, I didn't have a supply ship. I got... No, it was in the other one. And then I got into some baloney. So that's fun. Alright, what do you got? Things and more things. Almost all of them useless. Two walls and a thumb up my ass. That's what I got. This is the hard mode. Ooh, man, I'm not doing hard mode. I barely got in the village and I got bodied like immediately. Alright. Fine. Whatever. Not even a music disc. They're fine. You gotta be kidding me, really? Well, why not just follow this? I got stuff to hold. This is miscellaneous for now. Where the fuck do I find the quest? Oh, I think both of them at the same time, really. Turn filter off. I don't want to see that. That's probably worse. Alright, I'm gonna go to the bathroom. Probably take this off, because I'm getting it super dirty. I think I should just save and quit and call it there before it's too late.